The escalating fuel prices on the global market are not only becoming a burden to the local economy, but also constraining the individual consumer budgets. However, according to experts in renewable energy, the only lasting solution to this crisis is adopting the use of renewable energies.
We are doing what we call integrated energy development. We are cognizant of the fact that we do have oil and gas resources that we need to responsibly exploit, and this, in the wake of the recent happenings globally, you can appreciate that an integrated model is best adopted. And in as much as we are exploiting responsibly our oil resources, oil and gas resources, in the same vein, we are promoting, developing, and encouraging the exploitation of renewable energy resources.
It is estimated that at least 1.49 million tons of firewood is used every year in Uganda. However, with the intervention of clean cooking methods, this is expected to reduce to more than a half.
We had a task of creating jobs, and I must say that due to COVID and the high turnover, but also partners trying to learn how to hire for very specific skills, the number of jobs are not as high, but still these are opportunities created within the sector. There are over 1,000 jobs, but I think due to COVID, that number has reduced actually to 566.
The Swedish ambassador to Uganda says with limited and costly access to hydroelectricity, the Ugandan government ought to invest more resources in making renewable energy.
There is need for more. We see that far too many still doesn't have access to electricity, especially in rural areas, and as you mentioned, the cost. So this is, I think we should celebrate the results, but it's not doesn't mean that we stop or that we are satisfied with the situation as it is. We will continue and we will work with partners.
This was during a renewable energy fund showcasing by United Nations Capital Development Fund.